This video is a simple instructional guide to installing your EcoFlex undertile heating cable kit. It does not replace the installation manual included in the EcoFlex kit. Before installing the EcoFlex underfloor heating kit, please read the comprehensive installation instructions. If you are unsure of any of the installation instructions, please contact our technical helpline and we will be pleased to help. EcoFlex undertile heating kit is a complete heating element solution in a box. You will require the following accessories to install the heating system: thermal insulation, if required, a thermostat controller with floor limit sensor, and RCD, if not already fitted. Before commencing laying the EcoFlex heating cable, plan your installation using a sketch, marking your laying pattern and planning the positions for the wall-mounted thermostat, floor probe, and junction box. In new build installations, mark the position of floor-fitted objects that will be installed once the floor is finished. In kitchens, this could be kitchen carcass units. In bathrooms, it may be baths or showers. These areas should be avoided. Also avoid laying cables in areas where floor fixings may require to be drilled. We recommend that you spend time planning the installation and accurately calculate the free area of the floor that you want heated. This calculated area should then be used to select the correct cable kit size. Remember to subtract any areas covered with floor-fitted furniture. It is important to select the correct cable kit size as the cable cannot be shortened. EcoFlex cable kits can be installed on top of existing wooden or concrete subfloors that are sound and suitably prepared. Subfloors that have a rough finish should be prepared using a suitable levelling compound. On solid concrete subfloors, it is strongly recommended that EcoMax insulation boards are laid before installing the EcoFlex cable kit. This will ensure quicker heat up times and reduce running costs. On suspended wooden floors, it is essential that you take the standard precautions to stabilise the floor to prevent floor movement. You should always overboard a timber floor with a suitable surface for tiling. FlexL recommend WBP plywood or EcoMax insulation board. The insulation board should be laid using flexible tile adhesive or by securing using mechanical fixings. Scrim tape should be applied to all joints. The entire floor should be swept clean, taking care to remove any sharp objects. Ensure the subfloor is clean, dry, and free from any grease. Paint the prepared subfloor with the primer supplied with the kit. It is colour tinted for easier coverage control. The primer should be allowed to dry to a clear finish. This may take several hours dependent on ambient temperature conditions. Mark the layout of the EcoFlex cable on the prepared subfloor with a fibre-tipped pen. Mark the perimeter of the heated area together with the cable spacings obtained from the instruction manual. This will provide your cable laying pattern. Mark your cable start point. Ensure that this is close to the planned thermostat position. The EcoFlex cable cold tail is 3 metres long. Cable spacing and perimeter wall clearance must be a minimum of 50 millimetres. A heating system for larger areas will require two or more heating cables. It is important to note that when installing multiple heating cables to take the following precautions. Plan your installation so that all cable cold tails, the black power cables, terminate in one junction box. Multiple cables are joined in parallel. The orange heating cable should never cross at any point. Heating cables should never cross over the floor probe. A single thermostat can be installed to control multiple heating cables. However, the combined heat load should never exceed the rating of the thermostat. If this does occur, a suitably rated contactor should be installed. Before commencing laying the cable, cut a groove in the floor to accommodate the floor sensor for the thermostat. The sensor should be installed in the 12mm diameter flexible conduit supplied with the kit. The sensor should be positioned between two cable loops, approximately 500mm into the heated floor. Seal the end of the conduit with tape to prevent adhesive entering. Insert the sensor and tape to prevent it being accidentally removed. Insert the assembly in the groove and tape into position. Once satisfied with your marked up laying pattern, unroll the cable and lay in parallel loops using your pre-marked floor plan as a guide. Secure the cable to the floor using short strips of the adhesive tape supplied. At this point, only use a minimal amount of fixing tape, as you may wish to reposition the cable loops once the whole cable has been unrolled to achieve the best fit for the room. It is important that you do not remove the cable from the drum before laying, as it may twist and make installation difficult. Only unroll sufficient cable to lay a single loop. Place and tape in position before unrolling the next quantity. Always maintain a minimum 50mm gap between cables. The orange heating cables should never cross. The orange heating cable can never be cut. Don't lay the heating cable under any fixed furniture. Only install the cable on one level, never on stairs or up walls. Once the cable layout is complete, the entire length of the cable should be taped to the floor. This taping process will provide additional protection to the cable and prevent movement when applying the tile adhesive. When applying the tape, it is important to minimise the amount of air trapped between the tape, cable and the floor. Run your forefinger and thumb along the length of the cable, applying slight pressure to expel any trapped air. Check the cable resistance again to ensure it still matches the correct value. It is good practice to check the cable resistance regularly during the tiling process. If the resistance reading varies out with the tolerance, stop immediately and call our technical helpline. The heating cable is robust, however, care must be taken not to damage it during tiling. Use a piece of carpet or thick cardboard as a protective layer, or use a kneeling board to prevent damage to the heating cable from footwear or knees during the tiling process. Do not store or cut tiles on the heating cable. Use kneeling pads and rubber-soled footwear. Do not leave the cable unprotected if the finished floor is not tiled immediately. Cover with protective material like thick cardboard and minimise foot traffic in the area. Tile as normal using flexible tile adhesive. Gently comb the adhesive in the direction of the cable runs using a rubber back trowel to minimise the chance of dislodging the cable. Use a notched plastic trowel if possible. Take care not to allow the trowel to come into contact with the heating cable when applying the adhesive. Use sufficient adhesive to ensure that no gaps or voids are left under the tile. The thermostat should now be installed. All electrical wiring should be performed to the current wiring regulations by a professional electrician. Finally, fill out and complete the EcoFlex installation plan diagram and guarantee certificate. These are found at the back of the installation instructions. These should be completed, signed and left with the customer. The floor heating must not be turned on immediately after the tiling process. Consult the adhesive manufacturer for a suitable drying out period before turning on the heating system. This is usually around 2 weeks. For additional information on EcoFlex or any of our other heating products, please visit www.flexl.co.uk or telephone 01592 760 928.